Are you able to confirm that those are the three missing Israeli teenagers that were found today?
Yes, unfortunately I can. All Israel tonight is united in mourning the three teens who were brutally murdered by the Hamas terrorists. Unfortunately, there's no doubt about that. Hamas, I think, has shown us all once again what Hamas is all about. It's a brutal terrorist organization that has no qualms whatsoever about targeting civilians, and in this case, in kidnapping and murdering children.
Do you hold the Palestinian Authority responsible for any of this, even though they didn't have direct security control over the area?
It's clear that the terrorists came from areas under Palestinian Authority control and returned to territories under Palestinian Authority control. It's also clear that the pact that President Abbas signed with Hamas allowed Hamas to reestablish its presence in the West Bank and allowing these sort of attacks to happen. You know, President Abbas has signed commitments to fight terrorism, to have a no-tolerance policy for terrorism, and instead of doing that, he unfortunately has embraced Hamas. We urge him, we call upon him to immediately annul his pact with Hamas. How can he say to us that he's a partner in peace and reconciliation, at the same time be in a political alliance with these terrorists, with these murderers of children?
What will the Israeli response be? Palestinians in the West Bank are bracing, they say, for an Israeli military response.
Well, as we speak, the Israeli Security Cabinet is meeting in special session to discuss what's happened. Obviously, we'll be acting to try to bring the perpetrators of this terrible crime to justice and their accomplices, and we'll continue to act against Hamas in order to protect our people. Ultimately, it must be remembered that Hamas says every Israeli man, woman, and child, every civilian, is a legitimate target for these sort of terrorist attacks. So we're totally within our rights to protect ourselves against those Hamas terrorists who want to kill our people.
And what form might these operations take then in the West Bank?
At the moment, the Security Cabinet is still meeting. I don't want to prejudge what they might or might not decide. I can say the following. We think it's crucial at this time that the international community send an unequivocal message to the Palestinian Authority that, one, it start fighting terrorism. Two, that it break its alliance with Hamas. It break its alliance with these killers of children. And three, that it stop incitement. Do you know that the Palestinian Authority, in its official media and its education system, allows the most violent and extreme incitement to hatred and incitement to violence against Jews, creating an atmosphere where these sort of killers are considered heroes? That's unacceptable if they want to be considered a partner in peace.